We want to find the standard equation of the ellipse with foci 4, 0 and negative 4, 0, and the length of the minor axis is 6 units. The standard equation of an ellipse will take on two forms based upon whether we have a vertical major axis or a horizontal major axis. In both cases, a is greater than b, and therefore a squared is greater than b squared, meaning a squared is the larger denominator. So if the larger denominator is under the y part of the equation, as we see here, we'll have a vertical major axis. And if the larger denominator is under the x part of the equation, as we see here, we'll have a horizontal major axis. Remember, the major axis is the longer axis, which for this ellipse would be this axis here. And the minor axis is the shorter axis, which would be this axis here. Notice the distance from the center to the two endpoints of the major axis, also called the vertices, is equal to a units, and the distance from the center to the two endpoints of the minor axis is equal to b units, where the center is the midpoint of both axes. So let's go ahead and start by graphing the given information on the coordinate plane and see what information we can find. The two foci are 4, 0, which would be here, and negative 4, 0, which would be here. Well, we should recognize that the foci are on the major axis, and therefore we're going to have a horizontal major axis, so we'll be using this equation here for our ellipse. Notice the center is also halfway between the two foci, so this point here would be our center. So for this example, the center is at the origin. And then finally we're told the length of the major axis is 6 units, which means 2b is equal to 6 or b is equal to 3. So to find the endpoints of the minor axis, starting at the center, we would go up 3 units. This would be one endpoint, and then down 3 units from the center for the other endpoint. So this axis here would be the minor axis. So now let's go ahead and record all the information we can from our sketch. Well, first we know that the center is at the origin, so the coordinates would be 0, 0. And looking at our equation, the center has coordinates hk, so h is equal to 0 and k is equal to 0. Next, we already said that the distance from the center to the endpoints of the minor axis is equal to b units. And since this distance here is equal to 3, we know b is equal to 3. And also the distance from the center to the two foci is equal to c units. And since this distance here is equal to 4 units, we know c is equal to 4. So to write the equation of our ellipse, we also have to find a squared, which we can do using the equation a squared equals b squared plus c squared, which is always true for an ellipse. So we're going to have a squared is equal to b squared, and since b is 3, 3 squared is 9, plus c squared, well, c is 4 and 4 squared is 16, so we have a squared equals 9 plus 16 or 25, which is all we need to write the equation of our ellipse. We know a squared is 25. If b is equal to 3, then b squared is equal to 9. So our equation of our ellipse will be in this form here, where again h and k are 0, so we would have x squared divided by a squared, which is 25, plus y squared divided by b squared, which is 9, must equal 1. And again, notice how the larger denominator, or a squared, is under the x part of the equation because we know we have a horizontal major axis. So this would be the equation of our ellipse. Let's go ahead and finish by graphing our ellipse. Notice that we'd also still want to find the two endpoints of the major axis so we can make an accurate sketch. And the two endpoints of the major axis, or the vertices, will be a units to the right and left of the center, since we have a horizontal major axis. And since a squared is equal to 25, and we're only concerned about the positive value of a, we know that a must equal positive 5. which means the two endpoints of the major axis will be 5 units to the right and left of the center. So one endpoint would be here, and the other endpoint would be here. So our ellipse would look something like this. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.